All right, as you can see, this is the mirror that I brought from a customer. The problem that they had is the light here wasn't working properly. So they it has two buttons, one to turn it on and the other to defog the mirror. So I'm going to show you step by step how to fix it when you have something like that. So I just took it apart and I'm going to tell you what is the problem and how to fix it. All right, this is the back of the mirror. So because it has a Velcro, the only thing that you have to do is just pull it. Also, you will see the outlet over there. So all you have to do is take it out and that's it. So now I'm going to show you the problem that I found on this mirror. As you can see, we have the outlet over here that is coming from the other side and is coming all the way here. So we have two options, and I'm going to show you the first option, the easiest one. So as you can see, we have this bulge here. I'm going to tell you why. So as you can see here, this works with 240. So you can plug it in any part of the world. So the output is 12 volts, and it uses 36 watts. So the problem, in order to fix this is very easy. I want to tell you why. So as you can see, this is the electronic board that is inside. So if you want to leave it have the same functionality as before, this will be the trick. As you can see, this is the capacitor. So this is a normal capacitor. As you can see, you don't see anything black on the bottom. And here on this one, you see the rubber thing. The black thing on the bottom, because this swollen, and then that is why is like that. So this capacitor is bad. So if I replace this, truly it may work, but my only concern is because this is all yellow, it might overheat already. Who knows? So maybe I fix this and it may last maybe a couple weeks or month, and then it will break again. So my solution, if it's just for you, just see the size of the capacitor. So in this case, it says 16 volts and is 1000 microfarads. So you will see over there you go, 1000 microfarads and 16 volts. So that is what you have to buy. You buy that, the only thing that you need is a solder. So you just melt those two ends that you see over there, take it out, put a new one. There are thousands of videos on YouTube teaching you how to do that. Otherwise, it's not that difficult. Just you do that, buy something, put it back, sold it back, and everything should be good. So that will be one option. But my other option will be to do something more safe, in this case, something that is going to last longer, not safer, but something that's going to last longer. So I did a small hole, as you see here. So I'm going to put this here so that way the customer can turn it on and off like that. I'm going to install it over there. So we have these two legs over here, and one of the legs that you see here is going to go to this cable and the other to this cable. The reason is because you see it that way. We have the LED strip that you see over here. This is 12 volts. So with 12 volts power supply that you see here, it will work just fine. The problem that I have is the height. As you can see, it barely fits here. So I'm going to leave it like that. So otherwise I will use, you know, like a power split, but in this case, it's not going to fit if I try to use something like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to weld it here.
All right, in this video, we're going to teach you the theory. So here, before you do something, because before you start connecting everything, if you don't know what you're doing, give it to someone who knows what they are doing. Otherwise, you can die if you electrocute yourself. Otherwise, you can bring it to me. Or if you want me to help you over the phone, I can try to do that as well. So basically what you have to do, this is the first thing. You have the defogger here inside of the unit, in this case of the mirror, and then we have the power supply. The power supply is the one that is going to feed the LED light. So what you have to do is put it in parallel. Just that will be the first thing, so that way it will make your life easier. So you put them in parallel. Once you have done that, you can connect the one that comes from the 110, if you're in US, So you put it straight to one of the legs of the power supply and to the defogger. And then we have the hot. The hot is where we are going to install the switch. So in this case, that is where you want to have the switch. Once you do that, the circuit will be complete. So once you close the circuit here, you're going to have power. You are going to have 110 here. This is going to work. This is going to work when the customer switch off the switch. That's it. The fogger will be off and the light will be off as well. So very simple. Hopefully it was useful for you. If you have any question, let me know and let's continue with the practice.
All right, as you can see, it works just fine. So I installed the switch here, very easy. So now the only thing that you have to do is just do this, the diagram that I told you before. I did the connections, I welded as well, so that way it will not come loose. I'm going to glue it here. I'm going to put some tape here, electric tape. That's it. So I'm going to close it, deliver it to the customer, and that's it. So as you can see, it works just great. So we have the defogger, we have the light all together in one piece. All right, as you can see, I glue it. So we have the power supply here. I glue some of the cables so that way it's not going to be, you know, moving around. And now we have to put this back and that's it. So everything works great. All right, as you can see, we have the outlet over there. Now I have to take it to the customer and everything is good. All right, as you can see, it works great. Just with the push of a button, as you can see here. So I'll turn it off, turn it on and off. From here, and that's it. All right, it's working. Yep, worked great.